G'day guys, hope you're doing well. Today I just wanted to have a look at a figure bust from a company I haven't really heard of before. They may have been out for a while, but at the Brisbane Expo that I went to, Model Expo I went to, I found this on one of the dealer's tables, a spec mod. I think he's got a Facebook page where he sells his figures, so you can check that out if you want. I was walking past the spec mod table. I just saw this bust of this figure sitting on the table out of the box, and if I hadn't seen it out of the box, and I would have walked straight past it. I'll show you what it looks like, and hopefully you can understand why it sort of halted me, and I thought I might have to paint one of these up. So it was a limited edition. There was only 50 kits made, I believe. It comes in a decent cardboard box. And here's a nice little box art or picture of Nosferatu. If you're wondering who he is, he's from a silent film done way back in 1922. I think there's been some other versions of it as well. One in 1979, I think. And I think there's been some others as well since then. The limited edition number 50. I was lucky enough to pick number 24 up. Little plug there for Green Monkeys Models. I had a look on their website. They do have some other things as well. I don't know how, but this company sort of passed by me. I do get on websites weekly, and I didn't see this come up. Comes in a nice protected foam. Very few parts. You get his wrists and hands, and just the bust, and that's it. So very quick and fast to put together. So hopefully you can see here, I was walking past the dealer's table, and just the detail on this bust and just the texturing on the skin is absolutely unbelievable. There's a combination of skin. I think the sculptor was trying to have it as the skin was sort of flaking off or breaking off and showing a bit of a leathery texture underneath, is what I read. Make him a little bit more like a vampire in the body area. Just an absolute cracker of a sculpt. I'll put the hands on for you in a minute, but I thought I'd just give you a quick turnaround. The nice thing about this is there's not very many parts to the kit, obviously, so it's very quick. Bit of a painter's dream in that regard. Not much paint, gluing or sanding to be done. Very little in the way of casting lines. And just the texture on that back. You can sort of see a bit of the leathery sort of texture coming out there on the back there. Around here, and it's quite hideous, but in a very cool way. I don't do a lot of busts, but this thing just really caught my attention. Look at the veins going down its neck there, and it's just ugly, absolutely ugly. Sort of reminds me just a tiny bit of the Horizon vampire figure in 1/6 scale they did. Just that chest area for some reason reminds me of it a bit. Just absolutely hideous. Sculpt, but in a good way. And again around the forehead there, just the veins going through there and the bat-like ears. And just all the little indentations on the skull there. It's just a very nice sculpt. A lot of detail has been put into this bust. And just every angle on it, there's just some little muscular work or texturing that just really brings this sculpt to a very high level of workmanship. I'll close in on the eyes for you. Very hard to see, but it's very glossy eyes. I can't work out if they've just been polished or there's a little bit of glass in there or marble or something to affect. But as you can see, there's a bit of shine on the eyes. I can't exactly work out what it is, whether it's just very smooth resin with a gloss over it, or I'm not 100% sure. And when you add the hands to it as well, the hands are just as sculpted just as well. And it just gives an absolutely freaky looking appearance. I really can't rate this bust high enough. It's for a company I hadn't heard of before. Really blown away by this sculpt. And the other funny thing is, for something that is as nice as this, I can't remember seeing any on a competition table of any of the model shows I've been to. and I haven't really seen it too much on the internet either. So I was really surprised when I saw this. The only thing I like, it's very different from World War II or modern or sci-fi in a way. It's just a very different type of genre, if you like. Don't do too much in the way of horror, and this thing is dead ugly, but in a good way. There you go, guys. Hope you liked having a quick look at Nosferatu in 1/10 scale, and he's roughly around 9 centimeters tall in height, if you're wondering. Thanks a lot for watching, guys, and I'll catch you later.